Hi, and welcome to Rich Media Design Productions video on morphing. This time, we're going to actually use a morphing program that was designed to do the job of morphing one picture into another picture. This actually is a free software downloadable from the internet, and this one is made specifically for the Mac. So if you're using a PC, don't fret. There's other programs out there for you. I'm going to actually bring up my browser and show you where I got this program from. And here it is. It's called Norcross Morph X, and it's downloadable. It's norcross.com, and you can just download it for your Mac and start using it immediately after you finish this tutorial. Okay, for you PC people, you do have an option. You have a WinMorph, and that's on debugmode.com, and it's a program made for PCs. So here's a little bit of a kind of a helpful hint, if you want to put it that way. PCs and Macs, there's always been a fight about it, but they're starting to converge. They're starting to do similar things. They're actually starting to act similarly. So this program that you're looking at now, WinMorph, probably and most likely works as the MorphX does for the Mac. So it might do good to look at this this tutorial and see how it works, so that you can apply it when you download your own PC program. Okay, and here's another one. It's called Free Morphing, and it's downloadable on cnet.com. Okay, let's go on from here. I'm going to show you two images. One is a zebra, and I'm going to morph it into a horse. Okay, now this zebra isn't exactly like a horse, but it is similar to a horse, so you know, that helps. So when you're doing morphing, it always helps to have something that you're going to morph into. For example, key features are going to be important in morphing, like eyes or mouth or nose or you know, hands, feet, whatever. There's key features within one morph to another that actually makes it look like it's really happening, believable. Anyway, here's the horse, and if you'll notice, what I had to do, I'm going to bring it in here like that, so you can see them side by side. I had to put them reasonably in the center, white background, and I gave them the relative proportions to their natural size, because we don't want a zebra morphing into a horse that's the same size. That's not really believable. Horses are taller, so well, some are. Okay. Anyway, those are the two images that we're going to be using. It's going to go from a zebra, and it's going to morph into a horse. And this is an actual morph. Now, I'm kidding, because I got a few responses on a morph animation tutorial that I did that was specifically for showing people how to use the animation program. And it did a morph, and technically it was a morph. Even though people say it isn't, it is technically a morph, because if you look up the terminology or the definition, you'll see that a morph does change from one thing to another, and that's exactly what it did. But that other tutorial was basically to show you the animation feature and how you can do a morph using those animation features on Photoshop CS5. Anyway, we're going to go on and do this animation here, which is a actual morph using a program called Morph X. Okay, so basically it says there you can drop it right in. So I got the zebra. The zebra is going to morph into this image on the right, and you drop that image in there. Okay, so now you have the zebra and you have the horse. The next thing to do is start adding your points. Now, One of the things that I've noticed about morphing programs is that if you're using a black or white or colored background, it tends to, if you don't take care of those parameters in the morph, you're going to get a morph, but it's going to also show a kind of crimping or crinkling of the edges, because it's actually bending your image at the end, and you'll see what I'm talking about when we get there. So let's start. I'm going to start by taking care of those crimping or bending of the image by making a parameter so it won't do that, and I'll click here, and then I'll click here at the end, and then I'll click once more to release it, and then you'll notice that it appears over here on the right. Okay, next will be I'm going to do a parameter there, clicked it there. Now I go over here, and you notice it's going to appear in the same place or the same spot in the image as the previous, but what you want to do is you want to make it happen for the horse, so you're going to give that same parameter on top here, so you're going to make it move from that level to the next level. Okay, so I'm going to give it another go here. Some reason it's not connecting too good here. Okay, then I click it there, click it another time, and it disappears. Now what I want to do is take this and move it up here around where the eyes are and move that there. Okay, now I'm going to do a nose to, let's say, bottom, okay, or bottom to nose. So I'll click here. Come on, catch. And I'll make a move here to do similar to nose. And it's gonna catch about right there. Okay, now I'll do right about here, the image bottom, or you know, trunk, and then we'll finish this off real quick here. Okay, click again to release it. Move this out and up a bit. Okay. Now, something there. All you have to do is delete and it should be okay. Okay. What happened there? Delete and it deleted that. Now what do I do here? A nose. I gotta redo this here again. Okay. Come on, catch. Little stubborn thing here. I'm gonna have to drag that out now. Okay, same thing happened on the other side. Drag this out. And I'm gonna do the feet, and that's about it. I called them feet, but they're actually hooves. It out just a little bit more there, just to cover the change. Okay, and then I'm gonna have to do the same as I did to the top there. And we're done. Okay, next thing to do is to render the movie. Okay, so I just go up to the top menu here and press menu, or render movie at the menu. And then I'm going to go to settings, and I'm going to leave the size of the window the same, because if you change that parameter, you might get some distortion that you weren't expecting. But you know, this is something that you can experiment with it and actually have a good time with. I'm going to change the amount of frames to 25 so that you'll have, you know, a nice little smooth running animation, okay? And then I'll press OK. Then I'll press Save. And it'll ask me where I want it on desktop. And then I'm going to give it a name. Morph 1, let's say. Go ahead and save it. I'm going to bring this movie up. Make it larger so you can see it. Yep. Pay attention to the low resolution. These are actually low resolution images. And that's why you see the pixelation. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and play it. There you go. You have your animation. One more time. Now, here's an interesting thing about this. I was talking to you about taking care of the edge parameters. You see how it bent in here a little bit? You probably could have put one that covered this edge to the other edge, and that would have taken care of that one. The top and bottom were fine, and there was no crimping there. Anyway, that concludes your tutorial on MorphX animation. You have a great day, and we'll see you next time.